To the Molyneux we go. Newcastle United currently on a bit of a run in the league. 1, 2, 3, 4. A 4-game winning streak. And we tend to go on these little runs. Since the drop points against United and City, we've won 4 on the trot. Can we make it 5 out of 5 against Wolves at the Molyneux? There we go, into the starting lineups. Shearer and Kane, Andy Cole, my word. Okay, Luan, I'm going to give you a nod today, lad. You get in there. Ndombele will start. Ahead of Verratti, no. Let's see, yeah, let's give Verratti a bit of a break. Saint-Maximin will come on for Adama Traore. Elliot, Keita Knight, Kitazawa will come onto the bench. At the back. Jamal Lascelles will come on for Micah Richards. Shay Given will continue. And that will be my side today. Shearer and Kane. Andy Cole, who did provide the assist for Alan Shearer in the last game, he's back on the bench today. Wolves playing a 5-3. Oh man, not another 5-defender team. Oh man, okay, but never mind. Fabio Santos and Balogun up front. Two dangerous forwards. João Moutinho, the danger man in midfield. Come on, Newcastle. We need another win here, lads. And we are going to play with... it's as close as I can get. If I wear my green kit, it's going to clash too much. So here we go. At the Molyneux, Newcastle United looking to make it 5 wins on the trot. And you know, I won't say we're having a great season. We've lost 7 times this season already. But we're certainly making a fist of it. But it's just the teams above us are so relentless in their points getting. Yeah, good view of the Molyneux there. Like the evening matches, they just had a bit of atmosphere to the match, eh? And Leon Dedonka there is captaining the side today. And look at that piece of magician work there, walking right through the dugout. It's this new age stadium, man. You can do all kinds of crazy shit here. So here we go. Just be thankful you can get to see the Molyneux in pairs, which you cannot normally do. Shearer there and Saint-Maximin. Howard Bellis is 20 years of age, signed this season alongside Jude Bellingham, and he's done not too badly. Luan is a player who's fighting for his Newcastle life, you have to say. And Newcastle, you can see them running and running hard. And man, oh, Shearer there, taken out of it. Kane, trying to get a shot off Kane here. And Eddie Kane there, my word, did well. After Shearer was surely fouled there, look at that. The referee played an advantage and Harry Kane tried to make the most of it. I think it might have been too far out for a free kick anyway. And Newcastle looking to make a breakthrough here. Here's Harry Kane again. Oh, and an acrobatic clearance there. Howard Bayless now.
Now it's Bale.
Finds Gareth Bale.
Sweet feet.
Bale skips his man.
Cleared without competition.
And the referee says, oh no, no, Gareth Bale's been penalized. For what the hell? Ravanelli. Oh my goodness me. Now just remember that foul, guys, because it looked pretty innocuous, right? But it was called. I guarantee you there will be worse done to me during the course of this match and it will not even be called. Ah, oh, man, and Luan again. You know, just a season ago he was thriving in those positions. And now he gets there and doesn't know what to do with it. Yes, Shearer now. Finds Harry Kane. Harry Kane cannot finish. Come on, Harry Kane. Nicely manufactured opportunity there by Alan Shearer. Found Harry Kane. and the goalkeeper makes a good save. Damn it. And you can see Wolves, a team that starts off playing with five at the back and they're sitting really deep. Is Gareth Bale now? Can he do something? Oh my word, they skipped his man. Jean Moutinho beaten all ends up by Harry Kane. Look at that! Just hey, finger pointing, please don't do that. Harry Kane, I mean Gareth Bale, yeah, turned his man, got taken out, and the referee is just like pointing a finger. Hey, can you mind not doing that? Gareth Bale will take it instead and hits the post. Oh my goodness. Ah. And look at that header. Right. Oh, Mascherano wins it back. Well done. Javier Mascherano. Oh! And Gareth Bale does well to keep that one in. Mascherano finds Luan. Oh, fuck, man. And look at that. There is no Wolves player not in their own half. All 11 Wolves players playing in their own half here. It happens so often where only one team comes out to play any kind of football and the other team is there to make sure that no football is played.
And it's played forward.
And again, where is my midfield? Non-existent. Newcastle chasing hard. Game Leon. Martinez Quarta will clear the danger, and Shea Given wasting no time in getting the ball out. Finds Gareth Bale. Oh, goodness me. It's quite frustrating, guys. Credit to Newcastle, though. I mean, they're not losing their cool here. They've got to keep running, and look at Gareth Bale chasing hard there. And Harry Kane defending in his own half. Does well. Finds Gareth Bale again. Bale turns away from Jean Moutinho, tries to find Luan and finds nobody. A straight pass, Gareth fucking Bale. I mean, really. The guy is directly in front of you and you misplace that pass. And it doesn't matter how good you are in this game. If you can't pass the ball 2 yards in front of you, there's nothing you can do, because for all that you're trying to achieve, the game will make sure. And Mascherano here.
Already up and running for the second half.
That nothing that you try will go how you want it. And look at that, Shearer. Fuck off. Gets the ball and takes. Man, I'm sorry, ref, but yeah, I'll get booked for that, of course. The dunker there on the wrong end of a Harry Kane tackle. Do Harry Kane and Andy Cole wear the same boots? I think they both wear that gold shit. And Luan, yeah, come on, Luan, please, for heaven's sake. He sees Gareth Bale making the run, and Gareth Bale outpaced by some guy named Ait Nouri. And look at this now. Oh, he finds Shearer. Shearer opens the scoring.
No mistake.
Oh, thank goodness, Alan Shearer.
He has breathed life into the game.
Alan Shearer there gets the pass from Luan as Gareth Bale inexplicably outpaced by some unknown defender on the flank there. But Luan picked it up again. And Martinez there, well beaten in there. Ndombele found Saint-Maximin, who poked it through for Shearer. And look how quick he was closed down there by Jetson. God damn. If nobody's ever seen AI scripting before, if you've watched this season, you'd have seen it in all its glory. It's really frustrating to play against, but its game is outstanding once you get past it. And those of you who followed that Manchester United season will know exactly how good this game can be when you get past that scripting. And look at them coming forward again. Yes, Luan now. He's got Ndombele in support. Ndombele racing forward there, trying to find Shearer and fails to do so, of course. And look at that, easily holding off his man. But Howard Bellis made a sterner stuff there, trying to find St. Maximin and cannot do so. Shearer.
Well, that's where he wants it.
Howard Bellis, oh, can't win that header either. Newcastle now. Long ball forward for Gareth Bale. And look at that. Of course he defended that. Why not? Still just 1-0 though. Mascherano does well. And St. Maximin making a good run here. Oh, look at that. That first touch took him way further away from goal than it should have. What a ball that was on Ndombele, right? Saw the run, got him, and look at that. Took him at least 6 steps away from goal for no good reason. Anyways, that is how these things go, guys. That is how these things go. Raul Jimenez coming on. And Wolves on the attack again now. And that guy holds off 2 centre-backs all on his own.
Raul.
And Raul Jimenez there, and Howard Bellis there.
Keep calm and
does well.
That's the job in a nutshell now.
Ndombele now. Look at where St. Maximin is. He's basically in the stands. Ah, that pass sails straight past Luan. Stay calm, Cass. Stay calm. Andy Cole will come on for the booked Harry Kane. Kitazawa will come on for Mascherano. 10 minutes, guys. 10 minutes to go. Mascherano fighting well. Gareth Bale now. Kane finds Shearer. No. Oh, yes. Harry Kane gets the goal. For Newcastle in his last contribution of the match. It's about to be subbed out here, Harry Kane. Kane got the ball through to Luan, who sent Shearer through. Shearer hit the upright, and Harry Kane there, good reflexes. Just got enough on it to get past the goalkeeper. And Newcastle now finally comfortably 2-0 up. Shearer there should have scored. Harry Kane had to sort out his feet first. And he scores for Newcastle here. Kitazawa coming on. Mascherano. And Kane going off.
Has he done enough since his goal? Is the feeling that he's lost his appetite for another? It's difficult to be sure exactly what the
here comes. Ooh. Wolves. And Howard Bellis. No, that's Jamal Lascelles. I beg your pardon.
And
there's Luan now. Luan racing forward, looking for some movement. Find Shearer. Can he find Shearer? No, he cannot. Beautiful ball. But like I said, that pass will just inexplicably run about a meter in front of the player. And make him chase. And you lose vital seconds. This game is all about timing. And even a split second lost on a through ball means the opportunity is gone, right? And that few extra steps you take, the few meters to the left you got to go to collect the ball, it changes the way you play completely. But regardless of that, Newcastle United will walk out of your 2-0 winners at the Molyneux. Harry Kane there, receiving the ball after Alan Shearer was fouled. 4 men around him, got a good shot off in the end with the left foot. Well saved. Harry Kane, yeah, again pulling off a good save on the goalkeeper. Constant threat there, Harry Kane, starting to find his way. Gareth Bale with the free kick, hitting the upright. One of several times that Newcastle United hit the woodwork today. Sheesh. Harry Kane got booked as the frustration started to take hold. But Alan Shearer eased Newcastle nerves there with the goal. A pass from St. Maximin. Just toe-poked it through to Shearer, who turned Dedonka, the two captains there. And Shearer finishing clinically there. Really little to no space for Newcastle. Look at that first touch. It sent that ball cannoning off St. Maximin's foot. He got the shot off in the end, but really that should have been a much better opportunity than that. And Harry Kane joined Alan Shearer on the score sheet here somewhat fortuitously, but he'll take the goal. Look at that. A bit of Lord of the Dance shit there first. And Newcastle, 7 shots on goal, 6 on target. We're certainly pummeling the opposition. It's just AI will not allow us to run away, score as many goals as we deserve to score, it would seem. Elsewhere, Arsenal pull off another victory to hold Newcastle at bay. Manchester City back to winning ways. Manchester United losing to Liverpool at Old Trafford. Now that will set the cat amongst the pigeons. Chelsea defeating West Ham in the other big news there, other relevant news anyway. So Liverpool, the champions, two-time defending champions Liverpool, have now taken the lead in the race for the Premiership title. How about that? Newcastle United fighting as hard as they can, defeating Wolves there after a tough game, goals from Shearer and Kane, but still not making much headway against Chelsea and Arsenal above them. Is it already too late to make this play for top 4? I mean, really, how well do you need to play? Liverpool on 79 points already. Wow, amazing. So, join me next time as Newcastle face Crystal Palace at St. James's Park before the second leg against Atletico Madrid. Just want to take a quick look at my team here. How are we doing in terms of performance? Alan Shearer's got 40 goals already this season in 41 games. Wow. Harry Kane, a respectable 17 goals this season. Gaston's got 7 and 7. Adama Traore, 9 and 7. Gareth Bale scored just the one time this season and 5 assists. My word. Andy Cole's got 8. Goals for Luan, Elliot, Rafael Leao. Yeah, not much else, eh? Gareth Bale is the one anomaly there. He has really not contributed as much as I thought he would. But Kane and Shearer, already 57 goals between them this season. Sounds great when you say it like that. 40 of those have come from Alan Shearer. Thanks for watching, guys. Catch you at the next one.